Hello everyone, you are watching Torkan. Today I am going to present you a different deck which revolves around the next campaign's Siege of Fenris's mission Fate and Fury. In this campaign mission we will have troop for our keyword which will give us 20% of mission score, and from here we are going to collect two cards. In fact, Commissar Çelik, who is 10 copies of him, and then 3, 6 and 10 copies of this Cadian Shock Trooper, which I don't have, and has troop keyword in it, and also endless, and I am actually really looking forward to obtain this card. I am actually going to change my own Commissar Yarik deck with this card's addition for endless cards. Really actually synergized well with Commissar Yarik, also with Canonis Veridian and Magus Dominus Ivasnofon. And thus, in order to collect these two, we need a deck with troop. Well, most likely, by the way, the Cadian Shock Trooper's arrival is due to the fact that previous week's Warhammer Fest included a new Cadian Trooper Imperial Guard model with the really cool mask, and thus this special card also returning as well. I am quite excited for him. So I am going to present you two decks that has it, and I believe this one is going to be the best, the strongest in fact. With the Greyfax, for why you might ask, because it's completely trooper and it has 98 points unlocked. For troopers are really cheap. In fact, I am really confused that this 16 cost card is actually a troop. Wait, troop and trooper the same? Yeah, okay, they are the same. We are looking for the troop. With the Greyfax, it should be alright to leave this much. For every 5 unused deck points will result in a 3% buff, which actually gets us to 125 unused points. In our case, we will have 96, meaning with 95. So 19 plus 3, 57% stat and HP boost Greyfax will provide us, which is lovely. So let's go ahead and go through our deck. Our commander is a level 3 Inquisitor Greyfax, 44 ranged attack, 9 psychic attack, 39 melee attack with tier 2 inspiring presence attached to her. She is a powerhouse, and her roster consists of the Tempestus Scion with the Endless trait. Let's go ahead and upgrade him. I got a lot of copies of him from both campaign reward drops and also the ranked dwarves. This card, the Sister of Silence Witch Seeker, was actually a card that I used to use with my Commissar Yarik deck, but due to the fact that her trait is reducing chaos instead of buffing ranged, I removed her out of my composition. However, this will be a good chance to take another look at her, so let's go ahead and quickly upgrade her as well. And there you go, from 40% to 60% of her precision shot is increased. And this is the third card, the card whose price has actually went up from 4 to 5. Godfred the Demont Bard, the Crusader, who has a tier 2 trait, Taunt. Which is expected to be one of the powerhouses of this deck as well, with the boosted wounds and boosted melee. With a really strong taunt card is always nice to have, and thus this card should also protect our troops as well. Another card with precision shot, Stromian Grell, Voidsman at Arms, a card that is actually unlocked at a really high level, 40-ish or 50-ish level it should be unlocked, so I really have it at a low copy number. Regardless, Greyfax should give it a quite high firepower and also wounds as well. Grayfax also really uses well the Furious Charge and Precision Shot units for she actually boosts the attacks and thus when the card is deployed the amount of damage unleashed with the charge or shot is actually increased as well. And our fifth troop, let me also go through the backsides. These are all troops, don't worry. Tier 2 barrage bearing card, Adeptus Sororitas Battle Sister, let me quickly upgrade her. You can also check the troops from their looks. They cannot be special, you would most likely distinct them from the other elite cards. They are not characters, they are not elite, they are not HQs, and they need to be on foot. Most of the bikers, cavalries and etc. Cards are not troopers. Adeptus Custodes members are not troopers, and you can differentiate them from that. The only card you most likely wouldn't expect to be a troop is actually this card. The Amelia Novena, Adeptus Sororitas Sister Superior, and she is also a troop as well. She has shield, and finally we have the Skitari Ranger with target acquired 2, which is also a troop. Our 8th and final card. We are ranged heavy in this deck, which is lovely. So we have some sort of a team going on. Let me quickly go around this card. Hoplite is actually a card that I thought it was a troop, yet it wasn't. Yeah, and with these actually there are no troops left. So let's go ahead and find out whether if this deck is actually any competitive or not. Now that the ranked trophies also is reduced, we should have an easy match in my opinion. For in this whole, you might say tribal, the troop deck that we have went with, who has 7 troops inside, meaning you will receive 140 additional exp in the next mission campaign. Let's go ahead. And it's actually a mirror match. All right, they have low cards than us, I guess. Our deck has 7 cards, theirs has 6 cards. Wait, this is also a troop deck. It will be amazing. Anyway, let's go ahead and put our taunt card. Yeah, of course, I can't be the only one that had the idea to make a troop deck. And no, it's not. I actually thought this card was also a troop. However, it is not. It's not. It's an elite and an infantry. Also, in the 40k universe, the psychers are quite elite. And thus, expecting a regular psyker to be a troop is also unlikely. Once again, the card on the right is a cavalry that is not a unit. Putting a shielded unit in front of a poison unit is not very logical. So I am actually going to put my sacrificial unit in there. But the sacrificial unit, in fact, got strong quite a lot. Even the little Tempest Scion is actually got strong. He has now 30 attack, nearly increased its attack to 50%. Yeah, the 57% in fact, if my calculations are correct, that is. And we are going to tank 2 attacks and still not die. Yes, our Godfred will be poisoned, but the poison is only 4. I believe, in my honest opinion, poison doesn't scale and synergize well with Grayfax, for you can't increase the poison's damage with her. However, once again, the precision shot and Furious Charge are really quite nice with her. Also, Inspiring Presence are also good as well. For Grayfax, from her special rule will increase your troop stats, But an active, inspiring presence in the board will actually increase will increase the attack as well. That's quite nice. So I believe if a 15 card unit nearly achieved a double shot, I really want to get rid of the unit on the right. But actually, yeah, with the, it's only 28 and our barrage will not be good enough. So I am switching the cards on this way. Alright, I think that should be good enough. Yeah, just like that. And yeah, they have the they have the turn to attack. That's alright. Our sister will have enough firepower to unleash. So far it's going relatively fine. After the retaliation attack, let me quickly check the Grafex. Also, our Grafex has one level higher than theirs. Most likely RNG was on my side while collecting her copies. Also, this week's campaign we couldn't buy a Grafex from one of the campaign starters. I believe I think she didn't also featured in a 100,000 ish plasma deal, which is quite sad. Let's go ahead and see if our barrage can take down. Lovely, so we had a double kill and also melted the 50% HP of the card on the right. And also I'm going to premiere on 30 minutes later. After this match I should go for the premiere. And then most likely this video will be uploaded. Perhaps I can multitask as well. Yeah, Rook Trader is really strong, but what is the point using her? Once again, our deck is a completely troop deck and Rook Trader isn't a troop. I believe the only troop card they have ever played in this deck is the Sion on the center right now. So let's go ahead and get rid of their strongest card. Tempest to Sion will also, it feels really cool to pronounce Tempest to Sion. Okay, anyways, I am going to put my shield unit on there. I believe around 30 ranged attack will be retaliated from her. But also our sister has a really high HP, which is lovely. I will try my best to deploy my own Grafex Warlord as late as possible to not allow any chance for my enemy to deal damage to her. Alright, I am counting 88 and I believe it, yes, target acquires 15% damage. It's actually a double kill for us. One of the things that I couldn't see or actually didn't care. Yeah, I think, yeah, it wouldn't matter. It wouldn't really matter. Let me quickly check how much attack. Only 29, it's alright. Yeah, the Grafex has a really high attack. That's quite unfortunate. But they are going with melee and that's unbelievably high melee attack for the Adeptus Mechanicus infantry card on their side actually attacked for a lot of damage. Yeah, I don't really have a chance and I need to take this shot. I am going to deploy my own Grafex and perhaps with a charged psychic attack, even though most likely it will not be much. But regardless, I think it should be good. Let's go ahead and deploy our own. Let's see how much our own HP will be increased up to 265. We are higher than their double wounds. Yes, they are attacking us with their own psychic. We are retaliating with our own psychic. Alright, let's go ahead and see how much damage, and it's actually little. Let's not take any more chances and take her down with a single ranged shot. Yep, the infantry tribal with the Grafex actually works. You don't need to fill the rest of your cards. At the moment I have 188 card points. If I had 199, the empty points would simply increase. So you would actually have moved towards that 75% gap. And actually I have increased my own trophy number, which is lovely. This is the deck. Let me quickly show you again. All seven of them are troops. One troop. Our sign is a troop. Our witch seeker is a troop. As you can see, fourth keyword. The Godfred, our crusader, is a troop on the third lovely card. Our voidsmen at arms are also a troop, our fourth troop. Our fifth troop is a battle sister, lovely, at fifth. On sixth, Adeptus Aureus Sister Superior is a troop. And finally, our Skitari Ranger is also a troop, a seven troop. 140% additional XP bearing this deck with 98 empty points, meaning 57 additional attack and wounds are present and obtainable with this deck. And if you have actually 199 points available, that would actually mean 15 extra points. So 9% more, meaning 66% extra stats. So you can actually have a stronger deck than mine in case if you have 199 points unlocked. However, this is the deck. This is the deck that you will you may use in the next Fate and Fury campaign mission to get this lovely special Cadian Shock Trooper unit who has an endless trait just like the Tempestus Sign, which would most likely increase the effectiveness of your most of the Servants of the Emperor cards, but most likely the Commissar Yerik and Magus Dominus Ivasnafon, while perhaps with Canon Sveridin is included as well. So this is my tribal troop deck video with the Inquisitor Grey FX. I think this deck is quite strong, and I hope you will use this deck in the next campaign mission. And until the next time, I would like you to take good care of yourselves.